discussion on right bundle branch block with right upper quadrant axis or northwest QRS axis. ECG demonstrating right bundle branch block with right upper quadrant axis. RSR prime pattern in V1, RS pattern in 1 and AVL and V6 are features of right bundle branch block. The amplitude of R waves in lateral leads are quite low. QRS width is a little more than 120 milliseconds. The QRS axis is in the northwest region, right upper quadrant, which can mean either extreme right axis or extreme left axis deviation. RS pattern is seen both in inferior leads and in lateral leads. Hence, it is rather difficult to say whether it is left anterior hemiblock or left posterior hemiblock which is associated with the RBBB. PR interval is normal. Thus, it can be considered as bifascicular block. QRS pattern in chest leads show a clockwise rotation with S waves persisting up to V6. The slurred R prime in V1 and slurred S waves in lateral leads suggest delayed activation of the right ventricular myocardium, which proceeds by conduction through the myocardium rather than through the specialized conduction system of the heart. A brief review on right upper quadrant or northwest axis. Northwest axis has been reported in fleckanite toxicity. In those with QRS with 200 milliseconds or less, right bundle branch block pattern was more likely. In those with QRS duration above 200 milliseconds, ECG was more likely to show left bundle branch block pattern and northwest axis. In another study, it has been shown that in patients late after repair of tetralogy of Fallot with significant pulmonary regurgitation, QRS duration of 150 milliseconds or more and northwest quadrant QRS axis can predict marked right ventricular enlargement. That study had evaluated 20 patients with magnetic resonance imaging for measurement of right ventricular volume. They had enlarged and hypokinetic right ventricles by echocardiography. In a case report of northwest QRS axis in a patient presenting with chest pain, it was due to acute infraposterolateral myocardial infarction. Northwest axis has been noted in idiopathic left ventricular tachycardia. That 15-year-old male had multiple emergency room visits with wide QRS complex tachycardia having RBBB morphology and northwest axis. Ventricular tachycardia with RBBB pattern and northwest axis can also occur in hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. Northwest axis is noted in biventricular pacing with right ventricular pacing at the apex. When the right ventricular pacing is from the outflow region, the QRS axis is often in the right inferior quadrant. Northwest axis may be rarely seen in left ventricular pacing and right ventricular apical pacing, though these are not the usual pattern in these pacing locations. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.